So I got my first NIH-funded grant, an R03, and my the goal of the grant is to look at gesture development of infants and toddlers with hearing loss. My kind of long-term goal is to look at, to identify precursors to later linguistic success for children with hearing loss, both so that we can identify children with hearing loss earlier that are at risk for later language delays, but also so we can figure out what skills early on we can potentially manipulate or influence through intervention so that we can, again, promote optimal outcomes for children with hearing loss. So gesture development is kind of where my research is right now, because that's one of the earliest kind of precursors to later language development that we know of for children with normal hearing that we can not only assess, but also that we can potentially shape through intervention. And so the idea is that if for children with normal hearing, we can look at their gesture development to make predictions about what their later language development will look like, maybe that's also the case for children with hearing loss. But right now, it's a really understudied area, and there's a bit of controversy, too, in terms of how much to promote anything that is a visual strategy for a population that has deficits in their auditory skills, and so whether visual communication will kind of serve as a bridge for later language development, or whether it might allow children to rely on visual communication to the detriment of their auditory development. And so I think there are a lot of really exciting potential implications regardless of which way the findings go in terms of the role of gesture development in language for children with hearing loss. What has been most exciting and surprising to me is how readily families are willing to participate in some of these research projects. So I've just been very hesitant to ask parents to commit to 2.5 years of coming into my lab at regular intervals to let me videotape them playing with their children. And I even scaled back how much I was going to ask them to come in because it seemed like such a burden. But families, even when they don't receive immediate benefit for them or their child by participating in the research, they really are usually kind of on board with being able to do something that they know will help other children. And I've been very surprised and impressed by that. We ask them to do recordings in their home of their like full day interactions with their child. And when I think about that, I think, oh, what are privacy concerns? Or what if I'm yelling at my child and are they going to judge me? And you know, I just think I might hesitate a little bit. But these families are just really willing to do what their part to contribute to science that might help other children with similar obstacles to what their child is experiencing. So right now I have children coming into the lab, and I am, instead of having the research assistants handle those visits, I'm going into every visit right now as my grant gets off the ground. And that has just been really valuable. In the past, in the past 3 years or so, I really haven't seen any kids. There are research assistants who are collecting all of the data, and my job is to analyze it and write it up. But now I'm going in and I'm seeing these children, and part of that, it helps me to ask my questions more appropriately and to see what parents' concerns are and those interactions. But it's also just exciting to see young children at this period where they, you know, maybe have just received their cochlear implant, or where they're just having their first words or their first steps, and to be able to see as they're communicating with their parents successfully for the first time. And that part is just exciting. And it's exciting to be able to share with parents these insights that maybe they don't have. So I get really excited when I see a child use a gesture to communicate something, but parents don't always have that insight to know that their child is communicating with them. And so there are some limitations right now in terms of what I can share with parents, because I don't want to encourage any changes in behavior that wouldn't have happened otherwise because of my research. But there are other pieces that I feel comfortable discussing with parents, and it's exciting to be able to talk with them about their child's changes and to kind of encourage parents. They, you know, they all are working really hard with their children to communicate, and being able just to say to a parent, wow, I saw some nice skills in there. You were really talking a lot to your child. Even something that simple that doesn't necessarily influence what they do, it shapes the way parents feel about themselves and about what's happening in their lives, and it's just kind of nice to get to be a part of that again. I'm excited to finally be asking exactly the questions that I want to ask, and knowing that at multiple points along the way in the next few years, I will be developing knowledge that didn't exist in the world before. So I'm asking questions that didn't have answers, and now in the next few years, I'll be able to answer those and to share that knowledge with the world and create something that wasn't there before. So I'm excited about that, and I'm excited to be, you know, already thinking about my R01, which is the next step, and to start, I'm already, you know, thinking about what those specific aims will be. And I'm excited about that potential, you know, so 3 years from now or more, you know, hopefully less, being able to move into an even larger investigation and potentially one with even more of an intervention focus. And so to move even more closely to having an immediate impact on outcomes for children with hearing loss.